Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Sick of Survival. So, in the last episode, we have started this villager training hall, as you can see right here. And yeah, this is the start of my villager training hall that I'm planning to make really big. And yeah, with this these villages right here, I can turn iron into emeralds. As you can see, I have done that a lot already. And with these emeralds, I can trade those for quartz, as you can see. And yeah, if we go over here, you can also see I've already collected 3 sugar boxes full with quartz. And yeah, I still need 7 more. I forgot one right here. I still need 7 more for a big project that is coming up pretty soon, but not this episode, so I won't talk about that right now. But yeah, it's really big project and I need a lot of resources for that, but yeah, that's probably going to happen in the next episode. But yeah, as I said, we've built this in the last episode, and then I said that I would do some things in between the episodes, and I did. As you can see, I've now placed down all the carpet here. Yeah, I chosen for the black and the red carpet. I think that looks quite nice next to each other like this. And yeah, I've also replaced all the machinery behind the villages with just normal gray concrete. And yeah, I think that looks a little bit better than all the observers and stuff that was behind them. So yeah, I really like this now. And this first part of the village training hall is actually complete now, fully. And yeah, it works really nice. Yeah, as I said, I've already collected 3 sugar boxes full with quartz, so that's quite a lot. And yeah, I still need to do 7 more, but I will just do that off camera because it's not really interesting to watch. Now, I've also, in between episodes, made a map of my whole base area of or this Mushroom Island, as you can see right here. This is, of course, the iron farm. And yeah, this is where we're at right now. And yeah, this is the whole Mushroom Island. The mycelium looks really purple on the map, but yeah, that's the mycelium, and that's just the normal grass. And then you can see actually really well here what area of the island I have already fully terraformed, with all the grass and also the trees. And yeah, that's of course right here. And then you can see the area where I have replaced all the mycelium with grass, but not yet terraformed it really. And then you can see the area where I haven't done anything at all yet. And yeah, this is quite cool, I think, just to see this like this. And yeah, I really like this map. And also, what I want to do later on in the episode, I said in the last episode that I wanted to make a time lapse of me terraforming an area of the island in this episode. And that area will be this area right here. So this place right here, I want to fully terraform, just to make it look exactly like this area here. And yeah, that's something I want to do later on in the episode. But before I want to do that, you have seen the intro, of course, of the video where I dug a really big hole. And yeah, you couldn't really see in the time lapse, but that area was right here. So that was a cube right under the sea here in this area, and we can actually go and fly there real quick. So yeah, you can see that is that area right there, and when I look down into that, you can also see the hole, and we can of course go real quick under it or in it. And yeah, here we are in the hole, and here you can see in the time lapse you could already see that I put it up some lime concrete walls. And since then I've also added some portals, nether portals, as you can see. And yeah, you probably can't really tell what this is going to be, but this is actually going to be a really big creeper farm. And yeah, that's why it's just next to my base. Because of course in the Mushroom Island mobs can spawn, but right here they can. And yeah, this is a creeper farm designed by Logical Geekboy. Of course, link to that will be in the description. It's a really good farm, really fast, and that's also the reason why I want to build it, of course. And yeah, it's really big, and that's what I want to do in this episode. I want to make this creeper farm. Now, I'm not going to do that right now, because I haven't collected all of the resources I need for that yet. But yeah, later on I will make another time lapse of me building that thing, and yeah, it's going to give us all the gunpowder we need, of course. Mostly going to use it for the rockets, of course, because yeah, we fly a lot of the on the server, and yeah, we constantly run out of the rockets. We already have a mob farm, but yeah, that is really far away from this base, and also not fast enough, I think, for the amount of rockets I want. So yeah, you can also see slime spawning. That won't be a problem once the whole farm is built up. So yeah, but yeah, that's my plan for this episode, to make that creep farm right here. And I have actually already collected some of the materials I need for that. If you just go over here in this chest right here, you can see I got some lime carpet, and then a lot of glass, way more than I need, but I needed glass for other things anyway. So yeah, just 6 sugar boxes full with glass and 3 sugar boxes full with lime carpet. So yeah, that's already quite a lot of resources. Just need a little bit more, and then I can actually start working on that farm. Alright, so there's one last project I quickly wanted to show, and that's this thing right here. As you can see, it is a witch farm designed by Omenko. Of course, the link will be in the description. But yeah, it's really close to spawn, as you can see. And yeah, it works really, really well. We can actually go here like this. Here you have all the machinery, and here you have the platforms where the witches can spawn. And yeah, then we can go down here. We went with the option of killing them with entity cramming. As you can see here, there are 24 minecarts. You can't really see that, but yeah, that are 24 of them. And when a witch falls into that, it will get killed by that, and then the hoppers will pick it up, of course, and that will basically all get sorted into these chests right here. And of course, the biggest reason why we build this farm is for the redstone. I'm not sure yet, we got some redstone in that right now, but this gets emptied a lot, of course, because redstone is very valuable, definitely on the server with all the farms. But yeah, we can also get a lot of glowstone, as you can see, and some other resources. But yeah, it's not that important to us to get these resources. Of course, gunpowder is nice too, but it's not that much gunpowder that we get from this. So yeah, it doesn't really matter, but the redstone is the most important for us, and then the glowstone is really nice too. And yeah, this goes all the way up to a height where only the witch farm is loaded, and then the witch farm is quite fast, actually. We get a lot of resources from it. Almost no mobs at all are loaded, or caves are loaded at all. So yeah, the farm is really fast, and yeah, we are really happy with this. Yeah, now we have almost infinite redstone, of course, on this server. And that was really needed for some projects and just farms that we are planning to build and building. So yeah, we're really happy with this, and I quickly wanted to show that too. So, here we are, back at the Creeper Farm project, and yeah, as you can see, there are a couple of sugar boxes here, and these are all filled with the resources. So, here we have the concrete that I need for building blocks, then the carpet, and the glass, and as last, the birch trapdoors. And yeah, I also need some extra things like obsidian and signs, but yeah, that are small things and don't really need that many sugar boxes, of course. And yeah, I still need to collect some of these items, but not that much, so I will quickly do that. And then we can actually start the time-lapse of me building this thing. But before I do that, I quickly wanted to show one last thing. If we actually go into one of these portals here, they all link up into one in the Nether. Here we are. Oh, slime went too. But yeah. As you can see, there's actually something right here. This is the space all the creepers will come through, of course, and then will fall down and get killed. And yeah, there is the normal collecting system for this thing. But 1/4 of all the gunpowder actually goes into these hoppers right here, and then goes into the dropper tower there. That leads into a nether portal right there, and that leads into a storage system in the overworld that I also already made. And yeah, that way we also store some gunpowder in the overworld, which next to the paper or the sugarcane. So that way we can really easy get the rockets, of course. So yeah, that's quite nice. If we actually go right here, you can see here are the hopper minecarts collecting all the gunpowder, and then down here is all the other storage for the rest of the gunpowder that will be produced. If I find out that there's not actually enough gunpowder going to the overworld, I will get another 1/4, so the half of it will go then to the overworld. That's not that much work to make that happen. So yeah, if I find out this isn't enough, I will do that. But anyway, I will now quickly collect some resources, and yeah, then we can start the time lapse. So I hope you enjoy it. So as you can see, the farm is now actually working, and yeah, there are a lot of creepers coming through. Every now and then there are no creepers, but yeah, this is quite a lot of creepers as you can see. And yeah, you can also see I have changed the way they die right now. You can see instead of them falling down, that thing that I showed you just before the time lapse, they actually die from entity cramming. And yeah, that's because this system here didn't really work well. I found out that with just one player and no player in the Nether, the creepers didn't really fall down or something. I don't know. It was a bit buggy, and yeah, most creepers just died from entity cramming anyway in the portal, and yeah, that didn't work well. So I've changed that all up, and yeah, I still need to clean this all up, the system here. but that isn't, of course, that much work. And yeah, instead of them falling down, they will instantly die from entity cramming, as you can see. And that works really well, even if there's no player in the nether. And you can see there are no drops here. Instead, once the creepers die, the gunpowder actually instantly goes back to the portal. And in just a second, I will show you what will happen then with the gunpowder. But yeah, that works really nice. And this is a way better system for me. But yeah, this now works. And the farm isn't actually at full speed yet. There's still some improvements I need to do to make it even faster. But it's already really fast. And yeah, probably generates more than enough gunpowder for me, but yeah, I still want it faster, of course. Okay, so here we are back in the overworld, and here you can see the portal where all the gunpowder the creepers drop comes back in. And yeah, if you look really closely every now and then, you can actually see some gunpowder popping into the portal and then instantly get sucked up by the hopper minecarts below there. And yeah, here you can see every now and then there's gunpowder coming through this dropper and then goes into this water tube underground. And that water tube basically goes that way and then yeah, to my storage system, and that I will show you in a second. But yeah, this works really nice. And yeah, of course, the creeper farm is right there, so all the creepers go to the portals, then they die in the portal in the nether, and the drops basically come through this portal back. So yeah, that works pretty nice. And yeah, this farm is really fast, as I said before. Definitely check out Logic Geek Boy video about this, link in the description. It works really nice, pretty nice farm, and yeah, it's pretty good. But now I will show you where the drops end up. So if you go back here, it's basically right next to my villager area, villager trading hall. And yeah, here you have this area. This still needs cleaning up. It looks pretty bad right here, but yeah, here you can see all the gunpowder coming in, and it's already quite a lot that is in here. I haven't been AFK for long at all, so yeah, this is really nice. The farm works really good. And then right here is also where the sugarcane gets stored, so that way I can craft the rockets, of course, really fast. Just can take some sugarcane here, make it into paper, and then can take some gunpowder and then put it together, and of course I get the rocket. So yeah, that works really nice. And I'm pretty happy with all of this. Still need to clean this all up, but then this part of the project is all done. And yeah, the only thing I need to do to finish this whole creeper farm project is yeah, make it a little bit faster by lighting up the caves, of course, surrounding this area. And yeah, then that will of course mean that there will be even more creeper spawning. And then I also need to push these walls back a little bit, because that will improve the rates of the farm too. So if I push these walls like 10 blocks that direction and that direction and all the other direction, of course, the farm will be even faster. But yeah, I didn't want to do that right now because that's a lot of digging. And yeah, I will just do that when I have time for that, and I want to. But right now the farm is already really fast, so I'm pretty happy with this. And the caves surrounding this area aren't that much, because most of the caves are water caves, and that means there aren't mobs spawning in it anyway. So yeah, that isn't much work too. So yeah, I will do some of those things just off camera, and then this project is all finished. Now for the AFK platform, I do have an idea for that, but I'm not going to do that right now. So for now it will just stay like this, but probably in the future I will change that in something cooler. But yeah, for now this project is all finished. Alright, so there's one last thing I want to do for this episode, and that is to, of course, terraform this whole area right here. As I said in this episode before and in the last episode, I really want to make a time lapse of that. And yeah, that is something I want to do right now. So Right now I'm going to make that time lapse of me terraforming like this whole area here. It's a pretty big area. And yeah, that will actually be the outro of this Sick of Survival episode. So if you enjoyed today's episode of Sick of Survival, definitely make sure to leave a like and consider subscribing. And yeah, I hope you enjoy this outro time lapse of me terraforming this whole area. It's a pretty big area, so it will probably be really epic. But for now, thank you all for watching and goodbye.